Well, first tonight, the personalised South Aussie number plate that's triggered a national security scare. The owner was shocked and bewildered when he was told someone had reported him to the Federal Attorney General's Department as a possible terrorist threat, all because of his looks and the innocuous rego plate on his car. Hendrik Gunt reports.
If this one's offensive, and obviously it was to this person, then it should be withdrawn.
I can't believe it's gone this far. It probably has a lot to do and shows a state of mind of the people these days. People are obviously scared.
I'm writing with deep-seated concern and fear, wondering what sort of person may be driving the vehicle.
This is the Adelaide car that sparked a national security scare, more particularly because of its number plate, bearing the date of the terrorist outrage which killed 3,000 people in the United States.
Now, this particular person took offence to that.
An Eyre Peninsula woman visiting Adelaide had spotted the car, but it was the plate, combined with the appearance of the driver, that really set off the alarm bells. She wrote to MPs saying that...
To her horror, she saw the driver appeared to be a Middle Eastern man with a beard.
The constituent felt that it was sending a message and really came to me with concerns about how a number plate such as this might get approval.
Those bells were heard loud and clear by Eyre Peninsula State Liberal MP Peter Treloar, whose office was contacted by a fearful constituent.
And what have your investigations uncovered?
Well, I've simply written to the Minister here in South Australia, Minister Mulligan, seeking from him some clarification about how personalised number plates are approved.
But it was the federal member for Grey, Rowan Ramsey, who really pushed the panic button, setting off a chain of events which led to the federal Attorney General, George Brandis, with Ramsey claiming that his constituent had felt so unnerved by the experience that she
wondered if the vehicle was going to blow itself to bits right next to me.
Brandis sent Rowan Ramsey's letter to his state counterpart, Deputy Premier John Rowe, whose office took it up with the State Minister for Transport.
They say I'm a what? A terrorist?
Alex Fragnito's horror is understandable when you learn he is the driver of this suspected car bomb, although the Adelaide dad admits he's been involved with police before.
Hey! What's going on? Stop! Stop there!
Tell me a story.
So, who is Alex Fragnito really? His father is a migrant, not from the Middle East, but, as it turns out, from Italy. Some years ago, his son went to the USA as a news cameraman, specialising in emergency services reality TV. Coming back to Australia, Alex got a personalised number plate.
I wanted something that would say emergency, so I was looking for AUS, Australia, 000, our emergency number. Of course, it was gone, and I was still online, and I thought, hey, let me try USA 911 being their emergency number.
So, what was that police scuffle about 9 years ago?
Stop! Get down!
Alex had seen two police on foot chasing a man who'd allegedly robbed a nearby Harvey Normans of $50,000 at Marion. Alex boldly confronted the villain and made a citizen's arrest.
I jumped out of the car with the little camera rolling here and I was shooting another car. He had a car waiting for him with the door open. He was going to jump into it, a little silver Honda. And they sped off and I was rolling on that and I spun the camera around with noise coming out of the bushes. He was jumping over a fence into a residential property there. Mm-hmm. Walked over to him, and I guess he must have thought that since I had the camera kind of up like this, I guess he might have thought this was a pistol, and he freaked out. Mm-hmm. I told him to get on the ground.
The robber dropped to the ground and stayed there until police eventually arrived. Now, Alex is himself the suspect of something much worse, of being a terrorist because of an innocent number plate and his so-called Middle Eastern look.
What would you say to the person who owned that car?
Well, I think we need to consider very carefully the role we play in a broader community. Each and every one of us has to do that.
Perhaps I could introduce Channel 7 camera...
Is it yours?
I'm Alex.
I've had that plate for a while.
Yeah.
My family's from America.
I should show you the notes I made before this.
Yeah.
And that is, one was that it could be celebrating the anniversary.
Yeah.
Or it could be simply highlighting the emergency number.
Rather, you know, appalled at a person seeing the negative rather than the positive.
Yeah.
And going to these lengths, you know, bringing the government in on it when perhaps if she was that close to me at some point, instead of being frightened of me, maybe she could have come up and asked me why.
This appears to be a case of people being more alarmed than alert. What was it that US President Roosevelt once said? We have nothing to fear, but fear itself.
So will you now also be writing to the State Transport Minister, the State Attorney General and the Federal Attorney General and the Federal Member for Grey, Rowan Ramsey, to ease all their concerns?
I'd certainly be pleased to do that.
Arrivederci.